Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars.
There's a lot of kickbacks to dealers. A HoldBack is just one of them. When you have a car that's been on the lot through the new model introduction on the next one, they have special incentives that they rebate to the dealer. They don't advertise it. A lot of times the invoice of the car, in fact, an average, I've read in Automotive News, the trade journal for all automobile dealers, that the average amount of fees, you could call them, HoldBacks, packed into an invoice is about $4,000. So when you buy a car today, on average, from a dealer, and you pay invoice, you're paying that dealer $4,000 in profit. Never, ever base your purchasing decision on the invoice of the car. Number two, never fall for the old discount trick, and that is by inflating the asking price of the car. You hear a sticker price, you hear a list price. That's not necessarily the manufacturer's suggested retail price. That's the dealer's suggested retail price, and he can make it anything he wants to. They can inflate the asking price to the point where the discount can still pay the dealer a very large price, but there are a lot of things besides HoldBack. They have advertising fees. They have delivery fees. All these are packed in to the invoice for the purpose of tricking the customer into thinking he's getting a good deal. Another way you never want to buy a car is strictly based on payments. I don't care how small the payment is, if you make it for long enough, you're going to pay an awful lot of profit to that dealer. Terms today are as much as 7 years in payments. So you always want to base your purchase on the actual price of the car, not the discount, not the invoice or what you perceive to be the cost of the car, but the actual price, and get competing bids from at least three dealers. Now, I endorse a company called TrueCar. That's TrueCar. You can go to them online at TrueCar.com, and they will give you the prices on the dealers for that make car of the car description that you describe online. Three dealers in your market, and they will give you the prices on those three dealers. Now, when you go to a TrueCar price, the first price you see does not include the dealer fees, and the first price you see does not include dealer installed options and things of this nature. It's deceptive, in my opinion, and it's something that needs to be changed by TrueCar. But they do disclose it on the final page of the pricing, and they will show the added price of the dealer installed accessories and dealer fees. But be very careful that you see that the extra fees are added in to the bottom line price. They do give you that information, but it's not as clear as it should be. It's the best way that you can go to buy a car today. If you go out there and do it on your own, it's a lot of work. You're going to have to be very careful. You're going to have to do a lot of homework. And a simple way to do it is go simply through TrueCar. Most dealers, especially in this South Florida market, do have dealer fees. The average dealer fee down here is close to $1,000. There are dealer fees down here over $2,000. And you usually don't find out about it until it's too late.